What if the key to colonizing Mars is not building better rockets, but building a giant cable from Earth to space? Imagine entering a glass capsule in Singapore, hitting Mars Transfer Station, and soaring silently above clouds, satellites, and gravity's grip with 100,000 kilometers into orbit. Welcome to the mind-blowing reality of space elevators. This isn't just science fiction anymore, it's called Operation Tether. Japan's Obayashi Corporation is already planning to build a $100 billion space elevator by 2050 using diamond-strength carbon nanotubes that don't even exist today. China is fast-tracking a version using ultra-light graphene fibers that can survive meteor impacts. But, insiders say, United Arab Emirates is already building a prototype in secret. Even Google's DeepMind is training AI to manage climber logistics in real time. Forget rockets. These vertical highways could launch cargo to the moon, mine asteroids, or transport AI-managed satellites from floating ocean bases into the stars. This mind-blowing launch could slash space travel costs from $10,000 per pound to just $100, making space tourism cheaper than a business-class ticket. But here's where it turns dark. What happens if a rival nation controls this infrastructure? Or if space pirates hack the climbers mid-ascent? One math error and the entire structure implodes into a black hole. Some even believe this idea was seeded by ancient alien civilizations and the Tower of Babel. Those were primitive space elevators, which was Earth's first failed attempt, and now humanity is rebuilding one. The question is, no longer if we build one, but who builds it first? The sky ladder is coming, and once built, whoever controls it may control the future of civilization. Are we building Earth's greatest invention or the most dangerous structure in human history? Would you dare take the ride knowing there's no emergency exit? Stay tuned, because in this video, we will explore how space elevators could completely disrupt space travel, unlock trillion-dollar industries, and redefine Earth's connection to the cosmos. Let's break down the blueprint of a real space elevator and see how this 100,000-kilometer tether could actually lift us into orbit step by step. Space elevator works like a vertical railroad to orbit, using super strong materials like carbon nanotubes or graphene 1,000 times stronger than steel to support climbers powered by lasers, solar energy, or electromagnetic propulsion. A counterweight space station in geostationary orbit, like a cosmic anchor, holds the ribbon taut, while solar-powered climbers glide up at 200 kilometers per hour, carrying cargo and even humans into orbit at a fraction of current launch costs, dropping from $10,000 per kilogram to under $100 per kilogram. Here is the insane science that actually makes it possible: diamond nanothreads, a material 1,000 times stronger than steel that don't even exist yet, but are being lab-grown by Japan's Obayashi Corporation. The base station could be an ocean-based mobile platform near the equator to avoid storms and space debris, while the top counterweight would keep the tether taut through Earth's rotation. This setup enables a continuous low-impact launch system with no fuel, no pollution, and no gravitational forces, perfect for space tourism, asteroid mining, or Mars missions. Think orbital hotels, moon cargo runs, and even space-based solar farms. With China, Japan, and private companies already experimenting, the question isn't if we build this, but who controls Earth's first elevator to the stars. If rockets are the floppy disks of space travel, then the space elevators are the ultra-fast fiber-optic future. A single space elevator could launch 50,000 tons annually for just $100 per kilogram, compared to SpaceX's $2,500 per kilogram, saving $120 billion per year. Here is the math. Building a $100 billion space elevator pays for itself in just 4 months of operation, while rockets burn $60 million per launch in fuel alone. The climbers use just 1% of a rocket's energy by riding laser beams up a carbon nanotube ribbon with zero explosive risk and 24/7 departures with no weather delays. A Falcon 9 can carry 22 tons to orbit 20 times yearly. One elevator could move that daily for 100 plus years. This gets even crazier, as rockets waste 90% of their mass on fuel, while elevators are 99% payload. NASA confirms a lunar elevator would cost just $1 billion, which is 1/100th of Artemis missions, and could mine trillions in helium-3. But here's the kicker. SpaceX needs 1,000 starships to colonize Mars, whereas one elevator could do it alone. The catch, if we don't build it by 2050, China might control Earth's only space highway and charge others whatever they want. Ready to rise beyond gravity? Let's experience the first human journey on a space elevator from ocean base to orbit. Imagine stepping into a sleek, glass-paneled capsule at a floating ocean base near the equator. Welcome to the first-ever space elevator ride. No roaring engines, no countdowns, just silence and anticipation. As the elevator begins its 100,000 kilometers journey to geostationary orbit, there's no gravitational force, no turbulence, just a smooth, surreal ascent as Earth gently curves beneath you. At 10 kilometers up, your coffee floats midair in zero gravity bubbles, while the AI guide warns, "Don't panic. Your inner ear thinks you're falling, but you're actually climbing the tallest structure ever built." By 100 kilometers, the sky melts from blue to black, the atmosphere now a thin neon halo beneath you, while the carbon nanotube tether hums with resonant energy like a cosmic guitar string. Every kilometer reveals something new. Thunderstorms glowing like electric fireworks, satellites zipping past, the aurora dancing below you, and the moon glowing ahead like a destination waiting to be claimed. You stop briefly at orbiting stations 1 for zero-gravity luxury hotels, another for interplanetary cargo launches, and even one housing a space university, floating in the stars. As you reach the final platform in geostationary orbit, the view is Earth as a living, breathing marble, suspended in darkness. You are weightless, yet grounded by awe. The 8-day journey ends with a gentle docking at Ascension Station, where billionaire investors and asteroid miners cheer your arrival with space-grown champagne. Yet secret studies warn 3% of riders suffer orbit euphoria, an addiction to the view so intense they refuse to return to Earth. Will you be ready to take humanity's first elevator to the stars when bookings open in 2050, or will the ultimate FOMO keep you grounded? Welcome to the year 2060, where Earth's skyline includes a towering thread to the stars, the space elevator fully operational, revolutionizing the global economy beyond imagination. With launch costs dropping from $10,000 per kg to under $100 per kg, space access is no longer for billionaires, it's the new Silicon Valley. Megacorporations now operate zero-gravity manufacturing hubs, 3D printing pharmaceuticals, alloys, and microchips in orbit with flawless precision. Energy companies beam solar power from orbital panels to Earth 24/7, disrupting fossil fuels forever. Asteroid mining becomes a trillion-dollar industry, with rare metals like platinum and iridium extracted and delivered via climbers, turning deep space into the new oil field. Orbital tourism explodes as elevators offer smooth, safe, and scenic rides to luxury hotels above Earth's atmosphere. Goodbye airplanes. Hello, exosphere suites. Nations lease elevator bandwidth like digital real estate, giving rise to space-as-a-service models. Startups flourish in space agriculture, satellite logistics, and even interplanetary shipping, thanks to orbital ports acting as launch pads to the moon and Mars. Space insurance emerges as a trillion-dollar industry, covering everything from solar flare disruptions to rogue asteroid collisions. And here's the wild part. Space elevators aren't just Earth-bound. Lunar elevators allow materials to flow between the moon and orbit, kickstarting space-based construction and terraforming projects, turning the moon into the next Dubai. The first space stock exchange goes live in LEO, low Earth orbit, trading asteroid commodities and orbital assets. Here is the reality. Whoever controls this profit machine controls 50% of global GDP. The leaked documents warn this could trigger the first orbital Cold War. The question isn't if you'll invest, but how fast you can claim your slice of the cosmic economy before it's too late. But for all its wonder, there's one terrifying reality about space elevators that no one's talking about. What if the very thing that launches us into the future becomes our greatest threat? A snapped space elevator cable could become a 100,000 kilometers long whip, slicing through satellites at orbital speeds, triggering a $300 trillion Kessler syndrome debris cascade that traps humanity on Earth. A single solar flare could fly its electromagnetic climbers, stranding passengers in a zero-gravity death trap 36,000 kilometers high. Even worse, if hit by a rogue satellite or space debris, the structure could collapse, raining metal and fire from the sky. Terrorist hacks, AI malfunctions, or a solar storm-induced system failure could turn a peaceful ride into a deadly fall from the stratosphere, making the entire elevator implode into a black hole. And let's not forget geopolitics. If one nation controls the elevator, space becomes a weaponized monopoly. Insurance companies are already calling it the Skytanic. Yet private companies still plan to launch by 2050. Will this be humanity's greatest achievement or our most expensive tombstone? So the question isn't just how high can we go, it's how hard will we fall if something goes wrong. By 2070, space elevators could transform Earth into a Type 1 civilization, with orbital farms feeding billions, asteroid mines fueling fusion reactors, and daily commutes to Mars costing less than a plane ticket. By the year 2075, you will be sipping coffee in an orbital cafe, Earth glowing below like a living jewel. And you got there, not on a rocket, but by swiping your card at a space elevator terminal in Dubai, Tokyo, or even Nairobi. Orbital factories churn out supermaterials, spaceports launch, daily missions to Mars, and asteroid mined platinum floods markets on Earth. Kids take school trips to the stratosphere. Entire industries exist above the clouds, from zero gravity sports leagues to solar energy farms, beaming unlimited power back to Earth. The elevator isn't just transport, it's a gateway to the next civilization where climate-proof habitats, space-based internet, and interplanetary trade are the new normal. But the question is, when will this reality arrive? 2050, 2075, or sooner than we think? Will it be built by a tech giant, a government, or someone watching this video right now? The question isn't if, but when humanity takes this leap. Will you ride the first ascent? Or will your grandkids live in a world where taking the elevator means going to the moon? Smash like if you would book a ticket, comment your wildest prediction, and subscribe to Zillion School, because the future is climbing faster than we think.